where I used to go on a little street performing. You know, check it out. What I'm finna do right now is called swapping your space. Look at this guy down here. He's playing, right? He's playing his stuff. But see, I need this spot. I'm gonna give him a few dollars to get his spot, and then I'm gonna play for about 15 minutes. And we'll see what happens. Chill out, BET, chill, just 1 second. See how it stops, money talks. I gave him a few dollars, he stops. Give me a little time to play.
I wanna say thanks to you. I wanna say thanks to you. Wanna say thanks.
You know what used to frustrate me the most down here, and when I'm getting ready to hit a high note, a note that I've been practicing all week to do, and here come the L, you know, and it's with this big, loud sound, you know. Who told them to put an L here anyway, huh? It'd be Fridays, right? And it's time for pickpockets, right, to come out. You know, the pickpockets, I gotta tell y'all the real truth. So I have to, on Fridays I tie, it's like the biggest of the money. So I gotta tie my bag to my left foot. So, you know, when the pickpockets, they try to get rough and tough and they try to take my bag, you know, they have to take me with them because I just work too hard for the money. Got arrested one time for street performing down here. I don't know why I got arrested though. I had my license, my street performing license. But cops came and said, all right, Stevie, let's go.
The hood hasn't always been kind to R. Kelly. An incident over a bicycle left him fighting for his life with a bullet in his shoulder. The bullet remains there to this day as a constant reminder of how mean the streets can be.
This corner down here is where I got shot at, and we're gonna walk down here. It's not like I'm still there or you gonna still see some blood or something, but this is, it was a while ago. We'll walk down here. I got not a brand new bike, but I got a bike. And it was my first bike that I had ever had. And I was riding, I was test driving it. You know, we used to say, how y'all doing? I was test driving it and I was riding the bike down this way. And as I was riding the bike, I got up to this corner right here, and as I was finna turn around, somebody from this direction shot me and fell off the bike. I didn't know what had happened to me, but I fell off of the bike. And next thing you know, I was in the hospital. But something that upsets me about my people today, we're not together like we should be. You know, every corner I go on, every corner when we're driving around, I see a fight or two here and there, you know, and it's always, you know, I hate to see it being my people. And I feel that it's not like it used to be back in the old school. We was much more together. We was much more organized, you know. So if you see my people, tell them I'm looking for them.
Sometimes you...
R. Kelly's mother played a pivotal role in encouraging him to pursue his music. He grew up listening to singers such as Donny Hathaway and Stevie Wonder.
I gotta say, you know, my mother pushed me on and said, you know, I want you to go on, I want you to keep on doing this, you know, because you have something that God has given you that he hasn't given to everybody, you know, so I want you to go on and make this something that you want to do. Used to listen to a lot of Donny Hathaway, Stevie Wonder. I've been so many places in my life and time. I've sung a lot of songs. I made some bad rhymes. I
blasted out my life in stages with 20,000 people watching. We're alone now, and I'm singing a song to all of you. When I ask what happened to our miracle, you'll just say nothing's changed. Well, no need to hear those words again, girl, you're telling me you want to end and just be friends. Well, darling, there's no need to see this life once more. Honey, there's no need, I'll be the one to hit the door.
Mother, man, bought me two things. She bought me a Long Ranger set for Christmas and a guitar. I broke the Long Ranger set, and I started messing with the guitar. And everything's been musical, man, ever since.
R. Kelly has a personal interest in Born Into the 90s. It is a reflection of his experiences of growing up in the hood and a commentary on real-life scenarios.
I would like to think that my music is something that tells the truth. You know, it's not a fantasy thing, it's something that happens every day. And I feel that it's like that because of the fact of how I grew up, man. You feel this music because everything I went through comes out of my voice. It comes out in my playing the piano or my keyboards or programming my drums the way I do. It just comes out, everything that I went through. I've been in studio sessions, man, where I used to see big time producers when I used to say, man, I want to be a producer. I want to do this too, you know. And they used to spend like 3 or 4 weeks, man, on one song mixing, trying to mix it and trying to mix it. And then they were trying to mix a street sound. And I said, I would never do that. I was like, man, I'm going to go in. I'm not going to spend all of this crazy time trying to mix a street song. If the song is there, it was there before you even mix it. I truly wrote Honey Love sitting right here in this room one time when I got in my little horny mood I was in. I was wanting to be with somebody because I had been in the studio for so long and just writing day and night. You know, I wanted to get with somebody, you know. And I was working on a fast tune at the time that wasn't really getting me, so I wasn't feeling it. So I said, yo, let's break this all down. Let's just, you know, how you ball a piece of paper up and start from scratch. And Honey Love I came up with that night. Slow Dance came about, you know, hey, Mr. DJ, turn. I wanted it as simple and as plain and as street as possible. You know, hey, Mr. DJ, why don't you slow the party down? Because that's usually what people want to do after sweating for so long. And nowadays, boy, parties, they go all day before they slow the party down. And sometimes, you know, guys like me who like to get close, you know, to a certain girl I might see in the party that I like to get close to you.
The hits keep coming for R. Kelly. His newest single, Dedicated, recently skyrocketed to number one on the R&R chart.
Everybody probably obviously can see that's dedicated to my mother, you know. Because I respect my mother, man. I love my mother. We real close. We got a true friend relationship, not just you the son. You don't, you know, do this or you don't say this. You know, we talk. You know, I can talk to her. She's like my home girl, you know. She's not just a mother, you know. I respect her to the utmost. It's not hard to write a song like Dedicated when you think of what your mother went through. Almost anybody can come up with a song like that.
You, when your day is through,
You can go to McDonald's and get yourself a Big Mac, a Big Mac. Order of fries, icy coke, and an apple pie. No one doesn't like McDonald's, do McDonald's and you.
Let me get a chatter melt. Hey, baby. How you doing, baby? How you doing, baby? Hey, baby. What's up? I used to come to McDonald's and sing for my meal, you know. Bust out of tune, you know, before I became, you know, known. Okay, y'all take it easy. All right. What's up, man? What's up, man? Chill, man. Chill. I just had to stop and get me some gear because we gotta shoot a little ball. You know, sometimes you gotta prove things to people. Well, I gotta prove things to a couple of people from the company, Jive Records. And that's what I aim to do, so follow me. Hello.
Hey.
How you doing?
Fine. Ooh.
Just gonna see what color I choose to slam on him in. So I gotta have on a certain color when I rock nation. Yeah, give me some real baggy shorts so things could be a little loose, you know, when I, you know, on the car. So, I mean, don't get me wrong, I love my music. Basketball is home for me too. So we just gonna go to my hobby. And show you what I do when I'm not in the studio. Run, run, run. It's on.
Wait a minute, yeah, that was fucking, but let me get a